I'm Rattan Lal, Professor of Soil Science in the School of Environment and Natural Resources, and my professional interest is soil health, soil carbon dynamics, soil physical quality, and soil carbon sequestration in relation to climate change, with the hope that soil and agriculture can become solution to global issues. The World Soil Day is celebrated on the birthday of the late King of Thailand, His Excellency Bhumibol Adulyadej, means in English, Bhumi is soil, Atulya is unique, Tej is protector, force. Somebody who is a unique power force to protect soil. So in 2002, the International Union of Soil Science had its fourth year, every 4 year, World Congress held in Bangkok. Of course, the Congress being held in Bangkok, the King of Thailand at that time, in good health and well, attended the Congress, opened the Congress, gave his blessing to the Congress. And at that time, the International Union of Soil Science decided to honor him by celebrating the birthday, 5th of December, birthday of the King, as the World Soil Day. So first of all, I do want to congratulate all the audience that are meeting under the EPN auspices for the very auspicious day of the World Soil Day. Subsequently, after the inauguration in 2002, the King of Thailand took that issue to United Nations, and with his support and request, 2015 was declared the Year of the Soil. After the Year of the Soil, the International Union of Soil Science decided that the decade from 2015 to 2024 is called the Decade of the Soil. So the World Soil Day has a history of its origin through International Union of Soil Science, but I'm very pleased to say that the United Nations, especially FAO, based in Rome, has taken it up. They celebrated very enthusiastically. They also promoted the International Year of the Soil, and then IUSS has expanded this to a Decade of the Soil, which will end in 2024. And year 2024 is the centennial celebration of the International Union of Soil Science. It started in Rome. Celebration will happen again in Rome. So this is a brief history. I am very glad to see that this World Soil Day is celebrated globally, and that Ohio State is also celebrating it. Soils of the world, monitored to 1 meter depth, contain about 1,500 gigaton. Giga is billion, 90 ton of organic carbon. In addition to the organic carbon, soil also has inorganic carbon, and that amounts another about 750 or 800 gigaton to 1 meter depth. So to 1 meter depth combined together, organic and inorganic carbon, is about 2300 gigaton, billion tons of carbon. Compare that with the total carbon in plants, trees, shrubs, is about 560 gigaton alive biomass. The detritus biomass is about 60 gigaton. So total detritus, dead material, and the live is about 620 gigaton, which means a very small change in carbon stock in soil can have a large impact on the atmosphere. So the goal of climate smart agriculture is how to make soil and agriculture sink of atmospheric carbon. Therefore, soil done properly and agriculture done properly is a natural solution to climate change. And this message must be very clearly understood on the World Soil Day. That's why we need climate resilient agriculture. That's why I'm very glad that EPN is celebrating the world saw all day. I wish I were there. But I'm going to be in Spain talking the same thing at the climate summit. And I hope that I'll be able to accept your invitation next time. Have a great day.